それではもうスクリーンのシェアをもう始めていただいてもよろしいでしょうか。So, Silvia, could you start to share your screen, please?
Okay.
それでは、まあ、ほぼほぼ時間になりましたので始めましょうかね。So, could you start your talk, please, Silvia?
Thank you. Thank you to everybody for coming to this presentation, also from my side. And good morning from Italy, it's 7 a.m. So this presentation will be about the new application developed by HydroloGIS for digital field mapping, which is called SMESH. During the presentation, I will introduce you a general context of this development, and then we will see the application and some of its base functionality. So let me start introducing HydroloGIS. Maybe somebody of you already know us, but we are a very small engineering company placed in the northern part of Italy, in Bolzano. We are in two, Andrea Antonello and me, and we are both environmental engineers. The project, the open source project of which we participate and in fact manage are the ortho machine library in the fields of hydrology, hydraulic and forestry, mesh and geopaparazzi applications for digital field mapping, and the geopaparazzi survey server as a centralized server environment. We are both OSGeo charter members. So, we work in the field of environmental engineering, and we are very often in the field. So starting from 2010, we decided to develop an application, applications and tools for digital field mapping. The most known application we develop is Geopaparazzi, which has been translated in more than 15 languages, and it has more than 10,000 downloads now, and application all over the world. Unfortunately, in 2019-2020, we realized that Geopaparazzi needed a hard restyling because, first of all, because it is only for Android operating system, and then basically it has an old-style graphical user interface. So we decided to develop a new application, which is called Mesh. And SMESH is for smart mobile application for surveyor happiness. And basically it is an application to support outdoor activities for non-expert users. It has a user-oriented graphical user interface, and it is available for Android and iOS operating system. And it is free and open source. With SMESH, you can collect georeferenced pictures, notes, and GPS track logs. And it features a map view for the navigation and support for rasters for custom vector data. It is also easy from SMESH to import and export directly the surveyor data. SMESH opens directly in the map view, which you can see here, and features two sliders, so one in the left and one in the right, with the less common operations. In the bottom toolbar, there are the most common operations, which are starting from left. The possibility to take simple or form-based notes, the possibility to register a GPS log, the possibility to see the current GPS information, manage the layers you see in the map view, vectors and raster layers, and act on the zoom. Zoom with the fingers in the map is also supported by the application. Take care that all of these icons have different behavior if you tap just one, twice, or if you long tap. In the manual, there is always described. And the nice thing is that there is this data type counter for each of the data type you register in the field. From the last version, you can see on the upper part right of the bottom toolbar a slider, a very small icon, where you can open the operations toolbar, which we will see later in the presentation. Note that all the data registered in the field, notes, images, GPS log, are saved in a single project database, which is fully compatible with the GeoPaparazzi database. Regarding the layers, SNESH supports different formats for rasters, so you can visualize directly GeoPackage raster files, map URLs, TMS and WMS, Mapsforge offline.map files, MBTiles, and world images like tiff+png+jpg with the extension and projection files. Regarding the vector, we support directly GeoPackage vectors layer, GPX, and shapefiles, but shapefiles only in reading mode. All these vector layers are supported with the styling in SLD standard, both in reading and writing mode, and with their custom coordinate reference system. Just a simple, just a short note about the form. Follow the same specifications for the forms as GeoPaparazzi. So we highly suggest you to use the application GForm of the Otter Machine Library to create your forms and then copy them to the form folder of the SMESH application on your device. And the form will be automatically visualized in the application. SMESH also supports some simple import and export directly from the device. For example, complex notes can be exported to PDF and project data can be exported as GeoPackages. Another way to share the notes you are, the material you are collecting in the field is to synchronize the application's mesh to the GeoPaparazzi server, which is a web application that allows the users to synchronize the data in a productive way. So synchronize when you have a team of users and when you have a different version of the same notes and the same field release. On the side of SMESH, you can import, once you did the connection with the server, you can import and download centralized data, projects, and forms. So you can have this data centralized for and common for a whole team, both data, project, and forms. And then you can export the collected data and synchronize them with the central database. Note that the GeoPaparazzi Survey Server supports the versioning of the notes from different users and devices, also from different users and devices. The last thing that it is new in the new version of SMESH from version 1.5, in fact, you can see a small handler in the lower part, right corner of the map view. And this is the slider that activates the operations toolbar. In the operations toolbar, you can find all the interactive tools on layers and on the map view, and in particular, vector editing. Vector editing is available only for GeoPackage vector layers you can edit attributes, both attributes and geometries on all features on layers of all feature types, point, line, polygons, multi-line, and multi-points in their own coordinate reference system. And once activated, it works for all the layers of a GeoPackage type. And you can modify existing geometries, add new geometries, delete an existing geometry, and modify the attributes. This is an example of how it works for editing an existing geometries and adding a new geometries and editing the attribute table. As you can see, vector editing is thought to be used with the finger in the field. So I think this is almost everything for now. So if you are a user of Geopaparazzi, we kindly invite you to try to use Smash and to keep updated with Smash, because we are still developing it. And in our next steps will be improving the vector editing using the GPS position, the map center, and also introducing the SNET in the vector editing. We are also thinking about adding the possibility to register audio notes, because now it is only possible to register pictures, simple notes, and form-based notes. But audio will be helpful for people in the field. And then to implement the multi-language support, because now Smash it is unfortunately only in English, but we are working on the support of multi-language, and we hope that the Japanese community will contribute to the...
We lost her.
止まっちゃいました。
Hi, Silvia. Okay. Maybe she will return.
Silvia, can you hear?
Okay.
You are muted now.
Most of her presentation is done. I don't know. I don't see her at all.
Silvia.
See?
Okay. Yeah.
Did you hear the presentation?
Almost. Yeah. Probably we lost the last few seconds.
At the very end, the last slide, I think it happened.
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry. Should I do it again? Or?
No. We heard the entire. You had just said, "Oh, I think that's it," and then we lost you. So I think we heard the entire presentation.
Yeah. So I think we should move for the question time. Is that okay for you, Silvia?
Okay.
So, いくつか質問、あ、たくさん質問いただいてますので、いくつか取り上げたいと思います。So we have several questions for you. So I'm going to pick up some of them. The first one is this just my curiosity, but is Smash developed by native languages, for example, Java or Kotlin for Android, or Objective-C suite for iOS? So what kind of language is it?
No, Smash is developed in Flutter. Mm-hmm. So it is a multi-language. It is developed one for all the platforms and then compiled for the different platforms. And we hope very, very soon that also Windows will be supported for compiling.
Raster.
Okay, thanks. The next one is, can this work where in rural areas such as poor internet connection places?
Sorry, I didn't understand.
So is it works well in rural areas, like poor internet connection areas?
So Smash can work with data, with online data, both online data and offline data. So mm-hmm. if you are in a rural area and you don't have internet connection, you will prepare the data before, and then you can work, and then you can synchronize or export the data once you come back in the office or at home. Mm-hmm.
Thanks. The next one is, is this smart can use the map box beta tiles on the background.
Map box beta?
Beta type.
No, I don't think. I'm not sure, to tell you the truth, I'm not sure. But I don't think I should ask to the main developer, but I think we don't support.
So what kind of the tiles now you can use in this match?
MBTiles for rasters, or tiles in GeoPackage, or .map files, or all what was supported by Geopaparazzi, and then these are the things offline. Online, WMS and WFS are supported, all of these services.
Mm-hmm. Okay. The next one is from MapOS. Is there any good functions for OpenStreetMap surveys?
We are still thinking about it. We would like, but it is a bit difficult. But we don't know. It depends on the financing and on the possibility we will have. But we are thinking about supporting the OpenStreetMap. It would be our dream to support it.
Thanks. And time is almost coming, but I'm going to have a small question for you. Is there an extension to use RTK for summing?
RTK?
Yeah.
Not now.
Okay.
An external GPS, or what is this?
Okay. Then the last one. Do you have any help website for building up the GSS server?
If we have a website with the documentation on Smash, it's available. Yes, there is in the last slide. If you want, I can share it again. So you can see here. So you have to go to the Geopaparazzi website and then select the Smash application. Smash and Geopaparazzi start from the same website, and then you will have the full documentation of Smash available there.
Okay. Thank you very much, Silvia. It's just really wonderful tools. I'm really happy to use it. Thank you very much.
Thank you to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Also from Canada.
Enjoy. Ciao.